Hello, I'm Nathan Furukawa, and I'm the Senior Advisor for Hepatitis C Elimination at the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention. This presentation will cover strategies for implementing hepatitis C virus point-of-care testing. I have no conflict of interest to report, and any use of trade names does not imply any sort of endorsement. To start, let's review the traditional approach to HCV screening and testing as represented in this figure. First, a patient is tested for antibodies to HCV to assess for prior infection with HCV. If reactive, the patient is then tested for HCV RNA, which if detected, indicate viremia and current infection. There's some notable challenges though with the traditional diagnostic approach. This includes incomplete testing, where a reactive antibody is not followed up by an RNA test. An example of this is on the right, which shows hepatitis C care cascade data before the implementation of reflex testing. CDC recommends all reactive laboratory-based HCV antibody tests be automatically reflexed to HCV RNA testing. Additionally, the traditional algorithm is associated with longer times to diagnosis and higher loss to follow-up. Lastly, an antibody-first approach also may miss early HCV infections where a patient is viremic but has not yet seroconverted. In June of 2024, the FDA authorized a point-of-care HCV RNA test, which now unlocks the ability to test and treat hepatitis C during the same encounter. The Expert HCV is a CLIA-waived test run on Cepheid's Expert Express platform. To run the test, a larger Lancet is used to collect at least 250 microliters of finger stick blood in a microtainer. Getting sufficient sample can be difficult, but can be improved with hand warmers and gently massaging the finger to improve circulation. Finger stick samples are then viable for up to 4 hours after collection. Next, use a pipette to load the capillary blood sample into the Expert HCV cartridge. And lastly, load the cartridge and run the test. The Expert HCV has a 60-minute runtime that may be terminated early if sufficient RNA is detected. The reported result is qualitative. The availability of point-of-care HCV RNA testing unlocks being able to test and treat hepatitis C in a single visit. In November of 2024, the American Association for the Study of Liver Disease and the Infectious Disease Society of America released an HCV test and treat algorithm that consolidates all the pretreatment history, exam, and testing into a single visit. However, at the time of this recording, there is currently no point of care hepatitis B surface antigen test to rule out HBV co-infection, necessitating counseling around the risks of immediate hepatitis C treatment and follow-up of hepatitis B testing results. Thankfully, there are ongoing efforts to accelerate the market authorization of a point-of-care hepatitis B surface antigen test to address this gap. In determining whether to implement point-of-care HCV testing, there are three questions to consider. One, when can I use single versus two-step point-of-care testing? Two, what settings are optimal for point-of-care testing? And three, how do I pair point-of-care testing with hepatitis C treatment? The detailed answers to these questions can be found in an implementation considerations document published by CDC and found in this link, but I will provide high-level answers in the remainder of this video. Regarding the first question, point-of-care HCV testing may occur in a single step with HCV RNA testing or as a two-step process, first using a point-of-care antibody test that, when reactive, is followed up with a point-of-care HCV RNA test in a single visit. Of note, CDC guidelines recommend that single-step HCV RNA testing be used among people who might have been exposed to HCV within the past 6 months. In choosing a testing sequence, the advantages and disadvantages of each should be considered. The traditional laboratory-based two-step antibody reflex to RNA approach has the advantage of being widely available in almost all clinical settings and may be the least expensive option. However, as mentioned, it misses early HCV infection, requires phlebotomy and access to laboratory testing, and has a longer time to diagnosis. The two-step point-of-care antibody to point-of-care RNA approach has the advantage of being run on a finger stick sample, avoiding the need for phlebotomy or access to laboratory testing. Results are available in the same encounter, allowing for same encounter testing and treatment. Point-of-care antibody tests have shorter runtimes and can facilitate larger testing volumes during high-intensity screening campaigns. However, like the laboratory two-step approach, an antibody-first approach misses early HCV infection. Additionally, the point-of-care HCV RNA testing platform itself is more technically complex to set up and run. Lastly, the single-step point-of-care HCV RNA approach, in addition to the benefits of being a point-of-care test, can also detect early HCV infection. However, use of this testing sequence may be cost prohibitive in all but the highest prevalent populations. For more information about costs, it can be found in the implementation consideration document mentioned before. To answer the question of where to set up point-of-care testing, there are four characteristics to consider. The first is access to phlebotomy and laboratory testing. In settings with existing phlebotomy and lab access, the traditional laboratory-based two-step approach may be preferable, while in settings without phlebotomy or lab testing, a point-of-care option may be favored. Next, if a patient encounter is a brief encounter where you have a limited window to engage the patient, this favors point-of-care testing with immediate treatment initiation or linkage to care. By contrast, encounters that are part of a longitudinal relationship, this allows for either point-of-care or laboratory-based testing. Next, if the hepatitis C prevalence in a setting is low to moderate, then a two-step antibody to RNA approach may be favored since most people will not have hepatitis C, and a cheaper and faster test will rule out most people without hepatitis C. By contrast, settings with high prevalence may have high levels of ongoing transmission and high seropositivity, such that it is simpler to use viral first testing. Lastly, the volume of clients matters at the extremes. High-intensity testing campaigns favor two-step point-of-care approaches since the single-step approach is limited by how fast the expert HCV can be ran, which is 4 tests per hour on a 4-module expert express. On the low client volume side, implementing point-of-care HCV RNA testing may be unfeasible and costly if it's only going to be used intermittently on a small population. Taking all these concepts into account, we can think about what potential testing strategy might fit best into each setting. There's no one-size-fits-all approach, but this assessment might help point you in the direction of a strategy that will work best. So syringe service programs, opioid treatment programs, office-based opioid treatment programs, and carceral settings all have high Hep C prevalence. However, SSPs and OTPs oftentimes have limited or no access to phlebotomy or lab testing, making the point-of-care testing approach potentially preferable. Although jails have access to laboratory-based testing, the short nature of the interaction may push you towards a point-of-care testing approach. And then lastly, SSPs, OTPs, and office-based substance use disorder treatment programs all care for populations with the highest prevalence of hepatitis C, and so a single-step HCV RNA approach might be preferable. Other low prevalence settings for hepatitis C testing may include mobile units or community outreach, emergency departments, STI clinics, primary care, and rural settings. Given the Hep C prevalence is lower in these settings, a two-step antibody to RNA approach may be more cost savings. Point-of-care testing may be preferable for mobile units, emergency departments, STI clinics, and remote settings, since these are all brief encounter settings, where getting rapid, complete testing results is needed to initiate same-encounter treatment or link patients to care. Otherwise, for most primary care settings with ongoing follow-up, the traditional laboratory two-step approach remains a good option. Most importantly, you don't want to build a bridge to nowhere by implementing point-of-care testing without a solid plan to pair testing with treatment. The most effective strategy is to have treatment co-located with testing as part of a one-stop-shop same-encounter test and treat model. However, this is oftentimes not feasible in non-clinical settings where barriers to billing and reimbursement make these models unsustainable. Telehealth treatment has emerged as an effective substitute wherein a program can set aside space for a telehealth provider to meet the patient and prescribe treatment via mail order. However, some patients may be so medically complex as to need in-person evaluation. Mobile units can have integrated HCV testing and treatment services that are either brought to brick and mortar locations or operate in the field to provide high intensity testing and treatment. However, these oftentimes require larger budgets and grant funding from other sources to sustain. Lastly, settings without access to treatment by the above will have to refer out Hep C treatment. Patient navigator programs that link patients to treatment providers and support treatment initiation and completion can have favorable results that approach the effectiveness of co-located treatment if run well. To end, I wanted to highlight the potential for the test and treat model to transform hepatitis C care. This figure compares the typical workflow of HCV testing and treatment in Australian reception prisons with the test and treat one-stop-shop model of care. The test and treat model significantly reduced the time from prison entry to treatment initiation from 99 days to 6 days. Likewise, rates of treatment initiation increased from 22% to 93%. These data are really powerful examples of how a simplified approach to hepatitis C testing and treatment can improve outcomes and save lives. I hope this video has equipped you with the strategies you'll need to implement point-of-care testing in your practice. And thank you for your time, and thanks in advance for all the HepSecures you will achieve.